Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. Yeah, I just want to tell you guys something. You know, I do not sit around praying and asking the Lord, like, when's the rapture going to be and stuff like that. Because no man knows the exact day or hour, but we know we're in the season by the signs that the Lord gave us. And then the other independent signs, like I made videos of the road signs and personal confirmations that the Lord gave me. Lots of other people have personal confirmations too. But you know we shouldn't set a date. That's it. The bottom line, we shouldn't set a date. I mentioned that in lots of videos. Here's the point, though. We're in season. It could be any day. Okay, anytime. Could be months from now. It could possibly, hopefully not, but possibly even be years from now. I would say 90% chance, no. But only the Lord knows, and it's up to Him. He said He would come as a thief in the night. But you know, anyway. So I wanted to say that, and I also want to say that all the stuff that I've taught since if you go back and watch my videos, I've taught lots of things about the enemy's plans for his new world order and all that. For the last 3.5 years since I moved to this place I started renting here, I have, you know, I did most of my work in a real remote areas, and then, you know, because I've been here for 6 years, and so then the last 3.5 years, I've lived here, close to the city so I could have the internet and all that. Anyway, the Lord has had me by His Spirit leading me to study up on all the things of the coming New World Order from the negative side, looking at it from the negative side, the enemy's plans and how he does things. And so all the videos that I make is as the Lord would lead me. I just want to say that. Okay. So as an example, those of you who are my regular viewers, you know that I'm working on my wife's green card so I can come to the States and go around. And by the grace of God, there's lots of you who want me to you know, most of the YouTube viewers are like the only Christian in their family, and are they new Christians? You know, they don't have a church. Most of the churches have grown cold and fallen away as part of the end times. That's a big sign of the end times, as the Bible teaches us. So they don't have their own. You know, their pastor is like the on YouTube. That's where they get their pastoring from, me and others. And so the Lord has led me to try to go to the States and go visit you guys. Some people want to be water baptized. Some people want to be prayed for healing. Some people want to be prayed to be baptized in the Holy Spirit. They want me to be there and lay hands on them. Some people, and the biggest thing really is to evangelize their families, because, like I said, they're probably the only, most of the viewers are the only Christian in their whole family. So they're going to invite their friends, their relatives, and, you know, just like have a, you know, like the church is coming to them instead of going to a church to be evangelized, or even to a, you know, like a crusade at a, like a Billy Graham thing or whatever, which is great, but this is going, you know, I'm bringing it to somebody's house, and they can invite their relatives, things like that. Anyway, I was praying about that. You know, my wife's, you know, finalization. You know, she has to go for a final interview and all this, a physical and an interview, and it should already be here. And I've been praying for it so we can get it done in time for us to come, at the time frame we want to come, which is in May. So we're getting close because it takes probably about a month from the time I get notification to finalize it. So this is already the middle of March. Anyhow, I just wanted to say all that because I'm not sitting around praying and asking the Lord about the rapture. I'm usually praying about something else. In this case, I will say this too. I normally don't, and I'm going to say this because it's not for me. It's for lots of the viewers, okay? It's lots of you guys. Lots of people think that praying is just petitioning the Lord. I very rarely ask the Lord for anything or petition the Lord. 99% of the time when I pray, you know, the Bible says to enter his courts with thanksgiving in your heart, enter his gates with thanksgiving in your heart, enter his courts with praise. I will say this is the day that the Lord has made, you know, the day the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it, you know. So, I usually praise the Lord, worship the Lord, and you know, I'm worshiping him. I'm ministering to the Lord. Praise and worship is, you know, praising the Lord is, you know, declaring his glory. And worshiping him is ministering to him. And that's the problem, and that's the way the Lord uses me when I go to most churches. You know, especially your denominational churches. They look at the singing as a performance for the people. No. Singing is us ministering to God, praising him and then worshiping him, ministering to him. And then the preaching is the Lord ministering to us through one of his preachers, one of his servants. So that's how church is supposed to be. And just on that same topic too, whenever I go to church, I always tell them, and but they never listen. Move your offering and your announcements from away from in between the praise and worship and the preaching. When we minister to the Lord through praise and then worship, then the Lord's Spirit should come down in a true Christian Spirit-filled church. The power of God would move, and then that's the time that the pastor is supposed to be watching and waiting and listening for the leading of the Lord. Shall I have an altar call now, Lord? Shall I not preach and invite them to keep singing and have an open altar? Should I get up and evangelize? Should I change my sermon, Lord, and be led by you and preach on healing and then have an altar call for healing? Is that what you want to do today, Lord? You know, what do you want to do today, Lord? But instead, they get up grinning and smiling. And, of course, the offering is, you know, they need money to run the church. But grinning and smiling and, well, I'd like to wish happy birthday to Tommy and Susie. You know, that's class. I mean, happy birthday. That is, you know, people-pleasing, entertaining people and all about you. And that's what's wrong with most churches. That's why revival tarries, you know, in the United States. Because the people, it's all about me. if you would think about this, when you look at the comments on a YouTube channel, next time, lots of people love to keep commenting and watching comments. Okay. And this is what I observe. When I read people's comments, I observe that most of the people give the comment based, like, all about them, you know. You know, they'll say something, how this all relates to them. You know, instead of, you know, it's like they're the center of their world instead of the Lord. You know, you can, you know, Jesus said, out of the heart, the mouth speaks. You know, the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So we can see in someone's message, you know, or just observe what's coming out of their mouth, that it's all about them, you know, or all about doctrine or what, instead of all being all about the Lord. And then secondly, all about, you know, others. And then lastly, all about themselves. As an example, that's what I'm trying to say. When I made the videos about the end times, and I'm talking about what the Antichrist is going to do and all that, that video is for people probably who will be left behind or people who are not saved, you know, as part of evangelism. It's not, you know, if you're already a Christian, you're already walking with the Lord, you're already watching and waiting for the rapture, then, hey, you know, you don't need to hear it. But you can still zip it up and listen. Be quick to listen, the Bible says, and slow to speak. Maybe you'll learn something that you can use to evangelize someone else and stop thinking about, this video's boring to me. Oh, well, I'm sorry. May the Lord himself bow down to you and do your will. You know, I mean, let's start thinking about others. Think about, wow, you know, someone is going to get something out of this video. Or I can listen and learn something. I can use this information that can evangelize other people. God, Paul, you know, the Apostle Paul said that he becomes all things to all people that he might win some to the Lord. So, you know, we have to speak in a language that people can understand. Okay, so... just like people talking about when someone speaks in tongues, you should have a translator, the Bible says. Okay, so that people can understand you and be edified. So the same thing is true with what you say. You know, if I was talking to a group of, you know, if I was invited to speak to a church that was all truck drivers, the Lord would probably lead me and even, you know, I would be thinking of, you know, what can I relate to how driving a truck relates to the gospel, you know. We got to have our truck loaded and ready to move out. You know, we have to, you know, make it to heaven or what? I don't know. You know, you have to put your message to the people that you're talking to. You can't cookie cut the word of God. That's where the Holy Spirit comes in to lead you. I want to post this video right now because I always keep going on and on. I have 100 different topics in one video. I have a second video I want to do, and I'll just say it now. What I was going to say is that I was praying about my wife's green card, which, like I said, I very rarely petition the Lord. And when I do, it's usually for the people that ask me to pray for them on YouTube. And I don't even do that all the time and all when I'm praying because my focus is to love on the Lord. Jesus said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all these other things that you need there will be added unto you. So seek the kingdom of God and his righteousness. That's Matthew 6:33. That's probably the most important verse for a Christian in the Bible for anybody. Matthew 6:33. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these other things you desire, earthly things and healing or whatever, will be added unto you. Let me cut this off, and I'm going to tell you, while I was praying on that topic, the Lord gave me a vision. It's about the rapture. It was an awesome vision, and then I had a confirmation from a song that I was listening to. I always play praise and worship music when I'm ministering to the Lord and waiting on the Lord to hear from him on a topic. And, you know, I can just about ask the Lord anything and get an answer, but it takes time. You know, you could say, I'm trying to ask the Lord, shall I go to Pakistan or not and preach? You know, you just can't ask him and then 10 seconds later he's going to answer you. God doesn't play, you know, that we dictate to him when and where to answer. He might not answer you for a month, or he might answer you an hour later while you're, you know, you might go take a bath. You could be in the shower and the Lord might answer you. You don't know. You know, God is like that. But the Lord just gave me an awesome vision that I've never even, you know, the Lord, when he shows me something, it's usually in a way I never thought of. That's one way I know it's him. It's a total different angle of seeing things. And the Lord just showed me an awesome one that the rapture is imminent and a confirmation. Let me post this and I'll just get you fired up to hear that.